Hello everyone. In this video, I'm explaining co-occurrence matrix, which is a topic from digital image processing, and co-occurrence matrix is used for texture analysis of image. Now, image texture gives us information about spatial arrangement of color or intensities in the image. So what texture gives us? Image textures gives us information about the distribution, spatial arrangement of intensities of image. A simple one-dimensional histogram is not useful in characterizing the texture. Why can't we use histogram of image for texture analysis? So let's see example. You can see here three images. In three images, the number of gray intensity values and number of pixels are same, but their arrangement is different. You can see there are four white pixels in all images, four black pixels in all images, and then six gray pixels are there. So in these three images, the gray levels are same, but their arrangement is different. But if you find out the image histogram of all three images is same. And that is the reason we cannot use it for this image texture analysis. And hence, a two-dimensional dependence matrix, two-dimensional matrix that is known as co-occurrence matrix, is extensively used for texture analysis. The co-occurrence matrix captures numerical features of texture. What it means? Co-occurrence matrix captures numerical features. That means the features in the image are in the form of numbers. Numerical features of texture. Numerical features are calculated from co-occurrence matrix that can be used to represent, classify, and compare different textures available in the image. Now let's see how to calculate co-occurrence matrix. It has n by n size. What is n in this? N is number of gray values. That means if there are n number of gray values in the image, the size of co-occurrence matrix should be n by n. That is, rows and columns represents the set of possible pixel values. It is computed based on two parameters. So two parameters are important in this. The first parameter is relative distance, that is small d. Relative distance between the pixel pair. Pixel pair means what? This pixel and this pixel is pixel pair. This pixel and this pixel is pixel pair. This pixel and this pixel is pixel pair. Or this pixel and this pixel is pixel pair. What is d? D is the distance between pixel pair. And theta. What is theta? Theta is relative orientation or rotational angle. Now let's see what it is. Now there are eight directions of orientations of theta. Now let's see what it is. If we take the horizontal orientation, then we call it as theta equal to zero. If we take this pixel and this pixel, then we call it theta is equal to 45 degree. If we consider this pixel and this pixel, then theta is equal to 90. This and this, theta is equal to 135, and so on everywhere. Now let's see how to calculate with example. Suppose this is any image. So how many gray levels are there? 0, 1, 2 and 3. So pixel values are 0, 1, 2 and 3. So how many gray intensity values are there? There is n is equals to 4. So what is the size of our co-occurrence matrix now? The size of co-occurrence matrix should be n by n. So it is 4 by 4. Now let's take d. D is equals to 1, 0. What is meaning of d is equals to 1, 0? 1, 0 means I equal to 1 and j equal to 0. Now what is I and j? I represents rows. I represents rows and j represent column. Okay. So if it is written hash 0, 0, that means 0th row and 0th column. If it is 0, 1, that means 0th row and first column. So what are these values? These values are values of I and J. and we are taking example for theta is equals to horizontal. Horizontal means for theta is equals to 0. So we will be calculating for this direction. You know what is theta is equals to 0? Means this direction. That means pixel, one pixel should be here and another pixel should be here. We are taking horizontal pixels. We are considering the two pixels which are in horizontally, that are horizontally placed. Why? Because our theta is equals to 0. Now let's see what is the meaning of this and how to put values out here. What does 0, 0 represent? This 0th row and 0th column. What this 2, 2 represents? Second row and second column, and so on. Let's take one example. Now here what is given? D is equals to 1. That means horizontally we have to take theta is equals to 0. That means we have to take horizontal pixels. D is equals to 1. It is generally specified. It is x distance and y distance is not given. That means y distance is 0. So it is given ij. This is j and this is I. And this cell represent hash 0, 0. That means 0th row and 0th column. And we have to calculate in this image how many pixels are 0, 0. 0 means in horizontal direction, you have to identify 0, 0 pair. We have to identify pair of 0, 0. So how many pairs of 0 and 0 are there? This is one pair and this is second pair of 0, 0. Otherwise, there is no pair of 0, 0. So here we have to mention how many pairs are there? Two pairs are there. So here you have to write 2. This is how you have to enter value in co-occurrence matrix. Now let's do for another pairs. Now here I is equals to 0. What is this cell for? This cell is for, I is equals to 0 and j is equals to 1. That means pair should be 0 and 1. I is equals to 0 and j is equals to 1, but theta is 0. Theta is 0 means we have to consider horizontal direction. So how many pixels in the image with these pairs? So this is first pair and this is second pair and there are no other pairs and hence we have to write here 2 like this. So this is 2. Now next is I is equals to 0 and j is equals to 2. So we have to check out this is 0 and 2. Pair. So how many 0 and 2 pairs are there with theta is equals to 0 means horizontally placed pixel. So there is only one pair of pixel in which they are placed like this. So here we have to write 1. Now next is I is equals to 0 and j is equals to 3. So just check this image. I is equals to 0 and j is a means we need pixel pair like this. This is 0 and this is 3 in horizontal direction. So there is no pair and hence we have to write it 0. So this is how you have to write co-occurrence matrix. Let's take one example. Now we will solve this example. This is image. Okay. In this image, consider the simple 5x5 image. This is 5x5 image. How many gray levels are there? 0, 1 and 2. So there are only 3 gray levels. 3 gray levels means n is equals to 3. Now we are taking theta is equals to 135. So theta is equals to 135 means we have to take this alignment. This alignment means I am writing like this. We have to check this alignment of pixels. Now let's count how many pixels are with this alignment. So this is 1, 2, 3. How many pixels with this alignment? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So there are 16 pixels with this alignment. And hence, just remember, I have written 1 by 16. So we are going to multiply this co-occurrence matrix by 1 by 16. Or you can say we are dividing this matrix by 16 as there are 16 number of pairs. Why? To normalize this matrix. Now, what is this? This is co-occurrence matrix. Since there are only three gray levels, so it is 3x3 matrix because our n is equal to 3. So this is 3x3 matrix. You can write these are I values 0, 1, 2 and these are J values 0, 1, 2. So let's start one by one. That means I is equal to 0 and J is equal to 0, but in this position. What is this? In a 5x5 image, there are 16 pairs of pixels which satisfy the spatial separation. We divide co-occurrence matrix by 16 to normalize values. This I already told you. Now, I is equal to 0 and J is equal to 0. I am talking about this cell. In this cell, I value is 0, J value is 0. How should be placement? Placement of pixel should be like this. I equal to 0 and J is equal to 0. How many pixels are like this? There are no pixels with 0, 0 placements like this. Can you see in this image? There is no any pair with this position and hence I have written here 0. Now next, let's consider this cell. For this cell, I is equals to 0 and J is equals to 1. That means I equal to 0 and J is equals to 1. Now let's see how many pixels with this. I is 0 and J is 1. I is 0 and J is 1. These are two pixels in which I is 0 and J is 1. I is 0 and J is 1. And how many pairs are there? There are two pairs and hence what is written here? Here it is 2. Now let's see next. I is 0 and J is 2. I is 0 and J is 2. This is 1 and this is 2. Only two pairs are there and hence it is written 2. Similarly, check for I is equals to 1 and J is equals to 0. Means 1 and 0 and note down here. Then I is equals to 1 and J is equals to 1 and so on. Now let's take this example. That means I is equal to 2 and J is equals to 1. I is equals to 2 and J is equals to 1. How many pairs are there like this? There are three pairs. This is 2, 1, 2, 1 and 2, 1 and hence this is 3. So this is how you have to compute the complete co-occurrence matrix. The remaining values came with this only. And why we have divided it by 16? Because there are 16 pairs. In 5x5 image, there are 16 pairs of pixels which satisfy this spatial separation. Which type of separation we are talking about? In which theta is 135. I is here and J is here. Now let's take another example. Now this is an example of checkerboard matrix in which there are only two intensity levels 10, 10, 10, 10. That means this is black and this is white pixel. Now let's talk about this position. That means I is here and J is here and it is shown by this red lines. You can see 0, 0 position, 0, 0 position. Why it is shown? Because we are writing this. This is co-occurrence matrix. How many total such pairs are there in which this is the position? There are total 49 pairs and hence we are dividing this co-occurrence matrix by 49. Again, this is I is horizontal and J is this vertical slots. Now, what is this? This is I equal to 0 and J equal to 0. I equal to 0 and J equal to 0 means here it is 0 and here 0, 0, 0. So, it is shown by red marks and you can count these. How many pairs are there? And there are 24 pairs like this. Here, I is equal to 0 and J is equal to 1. No pair is like this and hence that's why it is 0. If you see this pair, I is equals to 1 and J is equals to 1. You can see how many pairs. This is shown by this mark, this color. This is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 and there are others many pairs like this. So if you count all pairs, you will get 25. So this becomes the co-occurrence matrix for this placement, this type of separation. Now let's do for another separation, means this type of separation. This type of separations means it is horizontal. In this theta is equals to 0. That means I value is here and J value is here. That means we are talking about adjacent pixels. Now again, same co-occurrence matrix. Now how many total pairs are like this? If you count how many total pairs, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. If you count all these pairs which holds this type of separation, there are 56 pairs in this image. And hence these values, co-occurrence matrix, we have to divide it by 56 for normalizing. Now let's calculate for I equal to 0 and J equal to 0. That means for this cell. That means in this position, here it should be 0. And here also it should be 0. And since it is checkerboard matrix, you will not find any pair like this. And that's why it is 0. If you count for this is 0 and this is 1. 0, 1, that is shown by blue color. That is shown by blue color. And there are other many 0, 1, 0, 1. This is also 0, 1. This is also 0, 1. And if you count, you will get 28 such pairs. And hence 28 is written out here. Then I is equals to 1 and J is equals to 1. There is no pair in which this is also 1 and this is also 1. And that's why it is 0. And then I is equals to 1 and J is equals to 0. That means I is equals to 1, J is equals to 0. It is this pair. It is shown by this color. And there are many like this. You can see there are many. This 1 and 0, 1 and 0. And if you count all these, you will get 28. So this is how you can write co-occurrence matrix for different separations. The theta should be known. We should be able to know whether we want to calculate for this position or we want to calculate for this position. This is theta is equals to 135. Here theta is equals to 0. And rest is similar. And in this, the one example is shown. This is image. This is 4x4 image. How many pixel intensity values are there? 1, 2, 3 and 0, 4. And hence co-occurrence matrix are also 4x4 matrix. These are J values and these are I values. And it is shown for co-occurrence matrix for different angles. This is for 0 angle. 0 angle means if you take the pixels where two adjacent pixels you have to take. 0 angle means in horizontal direction. 90 means this position. One pixel is here and other pixel is there, and you have to find out for this position and different values of I and J. And right here 135 means, you know, 135 means one pixel is here and one pixel is here. And 45 angle means this position, one pixel is here and one pixel is here. And you will get this output. I hope you understood how to calculate co-occurrence matrix of the image. And if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. Thank you.